Hello, I'm Elliott Antman, President of the American Heart Association, here in sunny San Francisco for ATVB PVD 2015. This is a fantastic meeting, and I'm delighted to be joined by several of the individuals who helped put this together. First, Dr. Kathryn Moore, Chair of the ATVB Council, Dr. Michael Conte, Chair of the PVD Council, and Dr. Muredach Reilly, who is the Program Chair for this wonderful meeting. This is a time when we can discuss the hot science in this field. So perhaps, Kathryn, you could start by telling us what you think is really going to be hot this year.
Well, we have a very exciting meeting this year. We're starting with an opening session on functional genomics, and then we have concurrent sessions for each of the areas of our council: arteriosclerosis, thrombosis, and vascular biology. And it's a mix of basic and translational science. And one of the exciting things about this meeting is it provides a lot of interaction for junior and senior investigators. And there are a lot of breaks in the program where people can discuss the exciting science and network, which is very important.
Wonderful. And Michael, you also can tell us a little bit about how the connection with the Society for Vascular Surgery has been incorporated into this meeting as well.
Yeah, for the last several years, we've had the Society for Vascular Surgery Research Initiatives meeting the day before this meeting starts, which has amplified, I think, the collaboration and networking that occurs here. This really is the meeting for vascular science, I think, so it's drawing clinicians and scientists together from around the country. It's very exciting to be involved in all of the translation that's going on here.
This is a very important meeting for the collaboration with ATVB and PVD. And Muredach, it's actually more than that. It's actually in collaboration with functional genomics and translational biology. And you had the responsibility as the program chair to put all this together. Tell us what you were thinking about when you assembled the program.
Yeah, it was a very exciting meeting this year to work directly with Mike and PVD to fully integrate with ATVB in the design of the program, as well as continue collaborations with particularly FGTB Council. So we have a really wonderfully integrated series of concurrent sessions with PVD on translational vascular medicine today. We have a strong emphasis, as always, on early career and early career sessions and young investigators. And then we have a cutting theme throughout the meeting on genomics, particularly cutting edge technologies in the application both on the basic sciences but how to translate this into translational science and to the clinical domain. So we have boot camps in genomics and how to use genomic information, as well as strong genomic sessions throughout the meeting, which cut through both PVD and ATVB themes and involve our collaborations with FGTB in particular.
The boot camps are a fantastic idea. I actually signed up for one of those on Friday afternoon. It's an important area, and I need to learn more about it. Can you tell us a little bit how that will work?
Well, I hope you did your homework, because to do the boot camp, it's a flipped classroom design, mm-hmm. where essentially you're supposed to read a few lectures on the material, do your homework before you get to the classroom. And in the classroom, then, it's really applied. It's applying that homework. So the idea here is that there's three areas in using ENCODE data, in enhancer mapping from publicly available data sets, and in CRISPR-Cas gene editing technologies. And these three themes are instructed upon by a series of young investigators who are all experts in the field, selected from FGTB Council and ATVB Council. And each of the participants, 120 for this boot camp, sit at a computer module with a group and work on real data to try and learn how to actually use this. So if you're a basic scientist, you begin to learn how to use publicly available genomic data. Mm-hmm. And if you're a clinical scientist, similarly, you can come to this. And this is an area where both ends of the spectrum of clinical science and basic science can integrate in genomics and translational medicine. So it's a two-hour session. It's a pilot this year. It's very exciting. We think it's something that will expand and roll out probably across other meetings as well.
It sounds fantastic, and I think the hard work that both councils have done in assembling this kind of program and the work that your program committee has done is really going to make this just a fantastic meeting. And as you know, everything we do at the American Heart Association rests on the very strong foundation of the best science, and this meeting here in San Francisco is emblematic of that. And in fact, many of the things that I'm sure will be presented and discussed will continue to drive our mission of building healthier lives free of cardiovascular diseases and stroke, and actually take us a long way towards our 2020 impact goal of reducing cardiovascular morbidity and mortality by 20%. You know, we have a tagline at the American Heart Association that says, life is why. But we need to remember, of course, that science is how, and community is where we will be implementing all the things that we hear at a very important meeting like this. This is Elliott Antman in San Francisco for Science News.